Todd Buchholz. More change, more people, more risk, more opportunity. We can't hide from the changes going on in the new global economy.
I'm going to start by giving you the first two words of a four-word cliche. And if you would, and I could tell by the fact you all arrived at such an early hour that you've got plenty of energy, I'd like you to supply the second two words. All right, the first two words are, here today, well, that's the way it used to be. Now it's here today, gone today. All right? We live in a world where technology is transforming the economy so swiftly, where information is changing and turning on its head our old ideas, that you can't depend that yesterday's themes, yesterday's ideas, yesterday's products, yesterday's customers and services will still be on your side when you go to bed this evening.
How can you capitalize on new markets while keeping the old ones?
Challenge is to reinvent it, because if it is not reinvented, I can assure you that the shiny, sharp, silvery blades of the business economy will cut, I'm afraid, many of you off. It is a serious challenge. Now, there are two ways to look at this. One is to hide, look for shelter. The other is to look for opportunity. I am, in fact, optimistic about the U.S. economy, about the world economy, about your industry as well.
He's a best-selling author of numerous books on investment and the economy, including Market Shock, 9 Economic and Social Upheavals That Will Shake Our Financial Future. His editorials appear frequently in the world's leading publications, including the Wall Street Journal. The media relies on him for his accurate insights into the world economy.
Talk to you first, huh?
And Successful Meetings magazine named him one of the top 21 speakers of the 21st century. From future trends to technology, business strategy to innovation, globalization to the world's financial markets, Buchholz's insights into these important issues will empower your organization to thrive in the new economy.
On World News Tonight this Wednesday, the Federal Reserve Board suddenly lowers interest rates. Why the surprise? What is the Fed thinking about the economy? And now for a little added value to this development, we go, as we have in the past, to the author and economist Todd Buchholz, who's in Washington tonight. Todd, this was certainly a preemptive strike in many people's mind by the Fed. Did you detect a note of panic at all?
Raise your hand if you remember the movie Groundhog Day with Bill Murray. Alan Greenspan is in his own Groundhog Day loop. Right? He wakes up, it's 1990. What's going on? Interest rates are too high. I raised them too high. Price of oil is sky high. There's a guy in the White House trying to call me. His name is George Bush. Right? He goes to sleep. He wakes up in the morning. 2001. What's going on? Oh, God, I raised interest rates too high. The price of oil is sky high. There's a guy in the White House trying to call me. His name is George Bush.
And with the internet and e-commerce cutting out the middleman, what does that mean for your business?
Imagine you're Richard Branson, chairman of and founder of Virgin Records. You're in your office a couple years ago, and one of your employees calls you. Sir, we have a problem. We opened that store in Times Square in New York, and it turns out we're finding out that kids aren't going to our store. They're ordering on computers something Amazon dot. What? How can that be? We need to get into that. A couple months pass. We found out now the kids, they're not just ordering the prepackaged CDs and records, they're deciding which songs they want the artist to sing on that CD before they're going to buy. What? We need to figure out how to get into that. Do it. A few months more pass. They're not just ordering one artist on a CD, they're kind of being their own producers, mixing and matching and then ordering it. What? How do we handle that? fix it. We need to get into that. Finally, sir, you know what? They're not even buying anything. They're just downloading it for free. Some now. Oh, my, you know, get me my balloon, right? It's like, what are we going to do? What are you going to do to maintain your business model in a world that's moving so quickly?
From his years as a White House advisor to his work as a corporate strategist with top companies from Wall Street to Silicon Valley, Todd Buchholz gives a unique perspective on competing and winning in the new global marketplace.
If each morning you ask your staff, are you empowering our customers? Are you making it easier for them? Yes, they want to keep up with the speed of the new economy, but they also want to be able to wind down at the end of the day. These are the challenges that the industry faces so that it can avoid being seen as the old economy.
Todd Buchholz. More change, more people, more risk, more opportunity.
The speed of the economy is amazingly fast. Maybe dangerously fast. It's gotten to the point where taxi cab drivers are, in fact, offering you stock recommendations. Imagine, guys who don't seem to know the difference between red and green suddenly have a very sophisticated view of the advanced decline line on the Dow and can tell you which stocks you ought to be buying. Americans have adopted as their national sport not golf, as you may be playing this weekend, not tennis, as you may be playing, not swimming, not football, nor basketball. Shopping is our national sport. Americans are leading, I see some Starbucks containers here, Americans are leading La Vida Latte. They're leading La Vida Latte. They're willing to spend $2 or $3 for a cup of coffee. It's been a remarkable burst of prosperity. And yet, I think there is danger. There is danger in all of this. The benefits of the internet, the benefits of technology, they don't necessarily go to you or you or you. These two with their $3 lattes from Starbucks, they may not be able to afford $3 cup of coffee in a couple of years. Why? Because the internet, while it enriches consumers, while it empowers consumers, while it allows all of us to shop online to comparison price, while it allows us to buy certified Angus ribeye steak directly online, while it allows you to buy New Zealand lamb chops cheaper than you may get them in your butcher's bin, it is wiping out the middleman.
Todd Buchholz. More change, more people, more risk, more opportunity.
What does Wall Street want in this environment? I mean, I think most people, I say, half of households now have money in the financial markets. Cab drivers, as I said, are interested in the market. What does Wall Street want from companies? And as you, in your investor mode, think about things, what should you be looking for? Well, first of all, Wall Street wants companies that can build a global brand. Yahoo is a meaningless word. I think it derives from Gulliver's Travels. But all around the world, it signifies the internet. Wall Street wants companies to build alliances, but it doesn't necessarily want them to consummate marriages that are monogamous. When AOL and Time Warner merged, the stock of AOL plummeted as a result. Wall Street wants companies to manage their expectations. Fess up to what you're doing right and doing wrong. Lucent has been punished several times, as I said, this year. And there needs to be the relentless focus on shareholder value. I mentioned Chairman Jack and DestroyYourBusiness.com. Customers, clients, demand an unbelievable amount of attention. They don't want to hear that you've got conferences to go to. They don't want to hear that you've got your own families to take care of. It has now become a 24-hour world. I was thinking about 7-Eleven. I wouldn't start a company today called 7-Eleven. I think 7-Eleven, you mean they're open only from 7 in the morning till 11 at night? What a lazy group of layabouts. What if I'm thirsty for a cup of coffee at 6:30 a.m.? Hell, we were here at 5:30 a.m. No one from 7-Eleven made it.